Yo, what's up? So, it's been like 8 hours on this 13-hour flight to New Zealand, and I think the people around me think I have to go to the bathroom a lot because I'm always coming here to say stuff. But the real problem here is I have to figure out, I'm kind of a sucker for romantic comedy films, right? I know, don't judge me. You are totally judging me right now, but I unfortunately ran out of I watched Knights of Redamping, and I haven't brought myself to watch High School Musical 3 yet, but I'm feeling like in 2 hours I might crack and have to watch that. Alright. So I just landed on the South Island of New Zealand on a kind of little plane right over those mountains. And you can see it's not too nice a day right now, but hopefully when I get into the mountains it'll clear up and look better. So I just arrived at the place I'm staying in New Zealand for the next couple weeks, and I know this probably sounds weird and you're probably rolling your eyes, but it's like a horseback riding farm, which means you just ride horses every day for the whole day. So, this is this room I'm staying in, right? And it's just me, but there's like there's four mattresses. And I'm not really sure why they did that, but I'll probably just like sleep on one for a different day of the week or something, you know, kind of like get it together like that. Right now, though, I've chosen this mattress because it has this awesome leaf design. I don't know if you can tell. I mean, it's pretty awesome. But I'm kind of tired now because I've been traveling for like 500 days. No, really just 3 days. But I don't even know why I said 500 days. Point is, tomorrow morning, I start horseback riding for 3 weeks straight, okay? It's pretty cool. You should be jealous. I know you're jealous. Alright, so the thing about this place is it's really cool, right? Because it's like a horseback riding farm, and it's like a bed and breakfast. And like I said, all you do is ride horses all day long. But they keep trying to give me vegetables for dinner. And I know it sounds like a 12-year-old, but I'm not that into vegetables. I can do apples, you know? Eat a lot of apples. I don't know why you need to know this about me. I'm just saying it, though. But it's always awkward every night because, like, the whole family finishes their plate and I'm like the little kid in the corner, you know what I mean? Anyway, hopefully they'll figure it out as time goes on. I mean, they have, like, three dogs, so I kind of try and put some of my food under the table to give it to them, I guess.
I just want to show you one of the advantages of living on a farm, okay? Not too bad, right?
Alright, so today we went eventing, which is pretty much the competitive side of horseback riding, in case you didn't know.
So that was pretty cool. But on the downside, I did kind of get a really, really bad sunburn, which hopefully will turn into a tan. But even if it turns into a tan, it'll be kind of creepy because it's like pretty distinctive, like on some areas. Kind of look like a popsicle right now, I think you could say. But would I do it again? Probably. There are so many animals on this farm. So we got Tippo right here.
Hey.
Who is one of three dogs.
Probably the cutest, too.
And then there are a bunch of rabbits. Like this guy.
Oh. We call him Mr. Rabbit because
We're pretty creative that way. And here, coincidentally, is Mrs. Rabbit.
Hey.
And then there's even a rabbit junior, I guess, which we'd call the kid. But clearly, we are not on a friend-to-friend basis yet because she's kind of scared of me. On top of the three rabbits, three dogs, there's a cat, and a hedgehog. Oh, and 85 horses. So, well, there we go. We're good friends. So it's living with a lot of animals. Probably more animals than people. Actually, definitely more animals than people since there's about six people who live on this farm. And maybe 95 animals. But all in all, it's kid time.
This is what I get to wake up to every morning.
So in the morning, what we do is catch our horse. Today, I'm riding Watson. What's the name of the horse? He's pretty cool. So I have to find Watson amongst all of these horses. And there's like a cheating way if you don't like remember, because we switch off horses and they have them written down on there. Here we go. This is Patsy, and this is a horse who's wants to be my friend. All right, I gotta go find Watson. All right, so Watson tried to run away from me, but here he is. First thing we do is give him a handful of oats. Good boy. And then we get him up and bring him back to the barn. It's pretty cool. So this is the worst part of the day where I have to clean the horse and I have this unfortunate colored paintbrush. It's tough. There we go. Holly, can you just keep
go get
so I'm hanging out on. Everyone around here has, if you can't tell, kind of traded in suburban life for beautiful, beautiful scenery. Although I did hear that they still show Gossip Girl on TV around here. Kind of disappointed about that, but it's pretty amazing just waking up every morning, getting on a horse, and looking out at that. I mean, all right, I know my camera works pretty shaky, but it's beautiful out here. So we're on top of this beautiful hill in the middle of some amazing countryside. Oh, and there's a bunch of cows over there. Typical day at the office. I hate cows. Just kidding.
peel up on the side.
If I can.
So, I am hanging out on Watson. Good boy right here. My good friend Holly is,
just about to go off the bank.
Is about to go off the bank, young horse. Where exactly are we going right now?
Around the corner.
We're going around the corner.
And then hopefully there's going to be a clearing where we can turn around and then go down the slippery part.
And then hopefully there's going to be a clearing where we'll again look very awesome and coordinated. And yeah, I'll stop talking now. That was pretty good, right? That was pretty good.
Still recording.
Most of you can't see this, but this is quite hilarious having Holly take all these photos for me. She's been kind of the laugh track to these videos.
So when a horse's horseshoe runs out, obviously you have to put on a whole new shoe, which is a little weird concept, having your shoes nailed to your foot. I don't know if I'd be cool with that, but at the same time I am not a horse. So anyway, today going out another trek, and as usual had a lesson this morning, and a lesson in show jumping, and I actually had my first fall, which wasn't great, but I feel like you can't be a good rider unless you've fallen off a few times, so kind of recovering from that. No, it wasn't that bad. Anyway, should be another good day.
There we are.
So, well, I'm trying to think of something to say other than slightly disappointed. No. What is it? Let's try this again. Just keep it going, okay?
It's slightly disturbing.
Slightly disturbing. So, as you can see behind me is quite a beautiful mountain. I'm so fortunate to be riding this wonderful horse in front of the mountain, too. I mean, this is just great. Alright. I think that was good. That was a good one. Oh no. I don't think that. Oh. So I'm hanging out in my backyard here. It's quite a difficult day for me to be riding. So cool. No, this is bad. This is just bad. That wasn't even funny. That's disturbing. That's
what
that was.
It won't go off! It won't!
I know.
Why won't it?
So how's your American accent, Holly?
Oh, bad.
And Holly turns away and rides away.
Oh, see,
I told you. Right, so another day at the office here. As you can tell, I got my good friends, the sheep, kind of hanging out at the base of this mountain. It's been about 12 days riding. I don't know if you can look, but my form's pretty fantastic. Get a lot of compliments around here for, alright, I'm kidding, I'm a really bad rider still. But I'm not going to give up because it's mighty fun. I don't know why I said that. Anyway, everything's good. Yes. Alright, I think you can turn it off.
It worked, turn off.
No, I don't know what you're doing. Is that bad?
Which one do you turn off? It's still not off.
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on. What is
so
it?
Holly
what
has
is
a
it?
Problem turning these things off because they just
they
keep
like
recording. It's the culprit over there.
Nice. Yeah, but you just push the red one, don't you? Turn it off. Silly flick.
Sometimes I wonder what my horse is thinking.
Hey, my name is Watson, and there's a big fat smelly rider on my back. It does bad kids movies. Oh no!
He said it. I mean, pretty accurate.
I'm not exactly sure how this happened, but we're kind of going through a river. Just walking through a river. Normal. I don't have anything else to say. I'm getting soaked right now. I'm soaking wet.
Oh, I don't know if you can tell, but we're kind of on this pretty steep hill right here. It's a bit rough. I think I might have to put my glasses on. Make sure. What else is there to say? We are how long have we been walking for?
About an hour and 20.
About an hour and 20, and I don't know about you guys, but I think I'm ready for some snacks. It's kind of that time.
Where am I gonna go?
No!
So kind of hiked up this mountain called Mount Oxford, that's what it's called, and there's a pretty cool waterfall up here, which I'm about to go see.
That's pretty sick on that.
Oh wow, pretty cool. Hey, what's up? So, I'm just hanging out right now, and, in Queenstown, which is, pretty south in New Zealand. It's, like, extreme sports capital of the world. So I'm pretty scared, because I think this town's famous, partly because it has a, the original bungee jump in the world, which is really terrifying, because I'm kind of scared of that stuff, but somebody decided to sign me up for it, so tomorrow I am going to be bungee jumping, and I'll bring this little camera along, because I'm not going to be the only one terrified here. Everybody watching is going to be pretty terrified, too. Anyway, hopefully I will make it all out in one piece, and I won't scream like a little girl, because that would not only be terrifying, but also embarrassing. Anyway, this is what the town looks like. We got mountains and lakes and more mountains over there, and then still this lake, and then me hanging out. I will shut up now. So I'm about to go bungee jump off of this place.
about to get on a helicopter to go mountain biking down a hill. Landed off the helicopter, about to go mountain biking for 6 hours. Hey, so it is my last night in New Zealand, unfortunately. I know, I'm sad, this place is great, but I got to do a lot of horseback riding and also bungee jumped and skydived and went in a stunt airplane and helicopter mountain biked and did something called riverboarding, which you should never do because it was really scary and involved just going down like rapids in a boogie board. Anyway, none of that's really that interesting besides the fact that did a little number on my hair, all of those activities, not that you need to know that. But for my last night in New Zealand, I got a little dressed up. I wanted everyone to notice my, this little guy right there, my tie clip, because I wouldn't be dressed up if it wasn't for that guy. But tomorrow I get on a plane back to LA, and then I get on another plane back to Maryland, which is where my dog Calypso lives, and which is where my heart is. But if you've been watching these, then I guess that makes you that much cooler, or it's just that much more embarrassing on my behalf. Either way, it's a good time. So, horseback riding in New Zealand. One of the many things you have to do on your to-do list, I know. All right.